today's lesson, we're going to take a look at Excel. We're going to get more comfortable working with Excel. And we're also going to take a look at all the different parts of the computer that you've been able to identify and realize what their parts are. So here's the assignment on our website. You're going to start by going to this Newegg website and taking a look at a computer. When you click on the website, it's just going to look like this. Here's a picture of the computer. And it's got a little bit of information right here, but you want to see all the details. We're going to scroll down just a little bit, and you'll see a specifications tab. So you're going to click on the specifications, and now you can see all the things that are making up this computer. So you can see the brand. Here's some quick info, and that's really handy, but if you scroll down, here's some really specific information. So the type of CPU, this is your microprocessor. It's going to give you some detailed information right there. The graphics card. If it says integrated, that means it comes with the motherboard and you don't have to get it separately. The memory is your RAM, and you can see that it's DDR3. It gives you some very specific information. The hard drive. The TB is a terabyte, so it's a really big hard drive. Your optical drive is your DVD player. It doesn't come with a monitor, but you're going to look for one anyways. The audio, you can see that it's integrated, so it comes on the motherboard. You could also upgrade if you wanted to get a sound card or a video card. The communication, so with going to the internet, it's usually on the motherboard. And then it tells you a little bit about the case. Keyboard is just your typical USB, and also mouse, and information like that. So you're going to be using this website, and you're going to look for these parts. How much would all of these parts cost? Now back on this website, on the class website, you're going to click on Price Watch, and this is where we're going to find the information. Let's first start by getting a spreadsheet from the backpack, or you can download it from below. When you open it, it's going to look like this. You can go ahead and come over here, and you can type your name, get that on your assignment, so you can get credit for it. Now we've got things organized by input, output, processing, and storage, and other. So here's a list of things that you need and some things that you can add if you want to, and you're going to put it into the spreadsheet here under component. So motherboard with CPU, where would that go? Well, it's processing, so I'm going to put it right here. A hard drive, that's going to be for storage. Memory, that's going to be, it could go for storage, but I'm going to put it here under processing because the motherboard uses it. We've got the optical drive. Okay, well, that's going to be for storage. Okay, monitor, keyboard, mouse, operating system. You're going to go ahead and put everything just where it's supposed to go. Operating system is none of these, right? This is our Windows, so we're going to put it here. For keyboard and mouse, we know that they're going to be input. And also for a monitor, that's going to be output. If you wanted to add a printer, you could add that here. If you wanted to add in a camera, so you can add more than this. These are going to be the basic parts that you're going to find the prices for. And then here's your list of options. So now we're going to go to Price Watch. And it looks like this, and you can see everything's really organized. So here you have motherboards and CPUs. Here you have your software. Here you have your hard drive. Over here you have your desktop memory, that's going to be your RAM. Here you have your mice and keyboards, and over here you have your monitor. So everything that you need to find, you can find right here. Let's start with our motherboard and CPU. We're actually going to come down to here with the combo. So we're going to buy a motherboard that has the CPU with it. Let's click on it. So it's all organized by the type of CPU it is. And we know that we have an Intel. Let's come back to this. We're going to take a look at specifically what do we have. So it's right here, an Intel Core i3, and it's a 4170. All right, let's see if we can find that. Intel Core i3. Right here. We want a 4170. Here it is, 4170. So I'm going to write down this information, and the cost is $146. So over here, where it says motherboard with CPU, I'm going to put down that it was a Intel Core i3 4170, and the source is Price Watch, and the cost was $146. Let me check that. And if you want to see what what it looks like, you can go ahead and do that too. So this is this one right here, $146. And you can kind of get an idea of the kit that you'd be buying. Now we're going to come back and forth. So the next thing we might want to find is our RAM. If we're going to do that, we're going to come over here. Just keep looking back. I'm going to come here to desktop memory. I'm going to look for that particular type. So I can see that it was 4 gig DDR3. And it can even be specific, DDR3 1600. So I can look for the DDR3s. And I'm going to look for 1600. And I want the 4 gig. So you can find it. You're going to put it on your spreadsheet. You're just going to go through and work on your spreadsheet, finding each part bit by bit. Fill it in. The source is going to be PriceWatch every time. You can do the specific part order and the cost. So get that far with this, and then we're going to come back and give you some more instructions.